operations in the Gulf are ongoing all around the clock, and many of the workers are at sea for weeks at a time. Hundreds of vessels and thousands of workers depend on deliveries of food and supplies. WDSU reporter Gina Swanson tagged along as one crew ship completed its resupply mission. Her report comes from the Gulf of Mexico.
After a 4.5-hour boat ride to the middle of the Gulf of Mexico, the workday for Captain Mark Welch and the crew aboard Miss Bet is just beginning.
You got every type of vessel you can think of out here working this.
Many of the vessels don't move, assigned to the Deepwater Horizon spill site for the duration of cleanup efforts. While the vessels are still, many parts of the operation are constantly in motion.
We carry personnel, supplies and stuff, whatever that barge needs out here. We bring it out there to them because they're out here. They can't go in, so you know, we just bring whatever they got to have. We bring it out here to them.
Jared Bourgeois is the vessel's engineer and head deckhand. He keeps up the engine room and helps coordinate deliveries. On this day, Miss Bet had to make three stops in the Gulf.
Well, we're transferring containers full of the booms, I guess, that they're using for the containing the oil for the fires. And I guess after a while, they get burnt out from being caught on fire and stuff, and we just swap them out every now and then.
It's a time-consuming process. Miss Bet pulls up close to a barge that houses workers. A crane is used to move freight containers from one vessel to another. Food, water, and supplies are offloaded, and workers are getting dropped off and picked up. Miss Bet is equipped with a small kitchen and sleeping quarters, a home away from home for people who are making a living on oil spill response efforts. Bourgeois says it's a small part of a massive operation, but with so much oil in the Gulf, it's hard to feel like his work is making a difference.
I think we're giving it a good try, but it's so much, and with the little bit that they're getting done and all, I don't think that they have enough boats around here to make a big difference about it. I think what they're doing underwater with the cabin and all that makes a difference, but us cleaning up the spill and all that, it'd be forever before it all gets done. It'll be spread out across the Gulf before we get it cleaned up.
After a 12-hour trip, the work is finally complete. But for the crew aboard Miss Bet, it's just another day on the Gulf. On your side, from the Gulf of Mexico, Gina Swanson, WDSU News.